Greetings, here is a small presentation on the importance of Sunday School by the students of St. Thomas Martimus Sunday School, Kharghar. The start of the Sunday School can be traced back to 1780 when Mr. Robert Raikes began a Sunday School movement in Gloucester for the children of the factories. In those days, the children worked 6 days a week and were only free on Sundays. He realized this was the best day for bringing them all together, and the first such meeting was which later grew extensively to churches and other public places. The teachers were lay people of the church, and the textbook was the Bible. The Sunday School movement proved to be a great blessing for the children and old alike, all over the world.
In the Bible, we see many instances where God tells people to teach their children about God. Deuteronomy chapter 31, verse 12 says, "Assemble the people, men, women, and children, and the foreigners residing in your towns, so they can listen and learn to fear the Lord your God and follow carefully all the words of this law." Although very little is mentioned about Jesus' childhood, we know that Jesus went to the synagogue to listen to the elders at the age of 12, which means Jesus used to go to the temple regularly on the Sabbath. In Mark chapter 10, we see that Jesus asking the disciples not to stop the children from coming to him. This shows that Jesus loved the children. This is exactly what our Sunday School Samajam and all the Sunday schools in the world are aiming, with the motto, "Come to Jesus, bring every child to Jesus."
The formal origin of the Martimus Sunday School Samajam was in the year 1905. Our forefathers and mothers realized this is an obvious need and began to engage the children by teaching them the life of Jesus Christ. The main decision taken there was to bring all the different Sunday schools functioning in the Martima community churches as an institution by the name the Malankara Martima Syrian Christian Sunday School Samajam. During the first 15 to 17 years of our life, the Sunday School plays an important role in preparing us to face the challenging world outside.
The first few years of Sunday School, I remember in my nursery class, the main topic was God's creation. It is through those colorful pages of a Sunday School textbook, our teachers taught us about this beautiful world God has created for us. I learned that it is our moral responsibility to protect and preserve God's creations for us and for our future generations.
As we grew, we were taught about Jesus' parables and miracles in our Sunday School lessons. These were very interesting, as these stories always had an inner message when Jesus wants to tell us. A few parables which still remains with me are the parable of the lost sheep. This parable taught me that I am the most important person for Jesus, and I will never be lost if I am under his care. The parable of the 10 virgins portrayed an important message of being alert at all times, as it helps us to be focused on the purpose of our life. The miracle of Jesus feeding the 5,000 is mentioned in all the 4 Gospels. This is an amazing miracle which taught me that I will lack nothing in my life if Jesus is with me. I remember the miracle of Jesus calming the storm, which taught me that there is absolutely nothing impossible with God, and all we need is strong faith in Him.
Growing up, I always wished to pray like my parents and elders. It was then, during one of my Sunday school classes, I was taught the Lord's Prayer. It was a simple prayer that I memorized so quickly. The meaning of the Lord's Prayer gave me understanding on how I should pray.
It's in the Sunday school that I learn about the greatest book, the Bible. The Bible has been my constant companion throughout my childhood. I understand that the Bible is a first aid to any problems I may face in my life. The Bible will continue to be my close companion and guide throughout my life. It gives me answer to all my doubts and queries.
In the Old Testament, God gave 10 commandments to the people of Israel through Moses. The first 4 commandments can briefly mean Jesus' first commandment. Love your God with all your heart, all your soul, and with all your mind. The last 6 commandments briefly mean Jesus' second commandment. Love your neighbor as you love yourself. I understand the importance of following these commandments religiously throughout my life.
During one of our general sessions, we were taught about the fruits of the Spirit. The fruit of the Spirit are love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. If we have these qualities in us, we can be sure that we are led by the Holy Spirit.
From the day of our birth, we are constantly in a war with Satan and his temptations. The armor of God consists of these parts. We need to always wear the belt of truth, the breastplate of righteousness, the shoes of peace, the shield of faith, the helmet of salvation. The sword of Spirit is the word of God, which is always alive and active in our life to judge our thoughts and actions.
It's through Sunday school that I could know more about Jesus. The 7 I am statements are powerful that would be our strength all the time. Jesus is the true vine, we are its branches. It's very important to be connected to the vine if we need to believe and be active. Jesus is the way, which means if we follow Jesus, we will never be lost. Jesus is the bread of life, not only to satisfy our physical hunger, but also to fulfill our deeper longings. Jesus is the gate and he stands guard so that I am safe and sound. Jesus is the light of the world. As we cannot see or lead others in the darkness, Jesus is the good shepherd. Jesus came to gather the sheep, defend, rescue, heal, and feed the sheep. Jesus is the resurrection and life, and he gives life and restoration for the entire world.
Now, Dad, we are at the senior years of Sunday school, learning about our church, its faith, and sacraments, which brings more meaning to what we need to do as the children of God. I understand that sacraments are visible signs of God's grace.
All these beautiful years of Sunday school has made me a strong person inside out, as I have grown in the wisdom of God. I guess as I complete my childhood years with the Sunday school, I am being equipped with the power of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit to face all the challenges that would come my way during my life on earth. No matter where we are, the tireless effort of our Sunday school mentors like our bishops, archons, and teachers will remain in us, and we will shine for our Lord Jesus through the valuable lessons we were taught in Sunday school. May God bless us all. Thank you.